Those numbers for us, and I do notice Bank of America shares down after trading up a little bit there in the early going, Wolf.
Yes, albeit I'm coming to that at the end of my hit. Let me start, if I may, with Citi pulling out of 13 markets within its global consumer bank, including the likes of China, India, Korea, Australia, and Russia. They'll now operate out of just 4 wealth management hubs in Asia and Europe. Those are London, UAE, Hong Kong, and Singapore. They remain fully committed in all markets, in the institutional business and in the private bank. This is a major step by CEO Jane Fraser as part of her strategy refresh. She told me earlier that, quote, while those 13 markets have excellent businesses, we don't have the scale we need to compete. We believe our capital, investment dollars and other resources are better deployed against higher returning opportunities in wealth management and our institutional businesses in Asia. She framed this as doubling down on wealth in that region rather than some of those pure consumer business lines. CFO Mark Mason outlined that it would free up $7 billion of capital, and those markets represented $4 billion in revenue and $3.3 billion in costs last year. He said the move would allow them to increase their commitment in those other business lines. Let's get on to the earnings numbers in particular. And both Citi and Bank of America showed similar themes to what we saw yesterday. Strong capital markets, albeit not quite as strong as Goldman Sachs, and a big EPS beat driven by the provisions for bad loans line switching from a cost to a benefit. Both also saw costs rise year over year. While that was expected this quarter, seasonal reasons and COVID, it was larger than expected. For Bank of America, it was up by $1.5 billion for them. And the reason the stock started to slide, David, was when they gave their guidance for full-year costs. I think some had expected it would be a one-off quarter. They'd make it up, keep the same guidance in the other three quarters, but they didn't. They increased guidance for the full-year cost by $1.5 billion. As well. So that extra cost in Q1 tacked on to their full year guidance now. That kind of triggered the initial selling for Bank of America. They were able, though, to upgrade net interest income outlook for the full year by $1 billion, highlights their sort of sensitivity to the yield curve. But either way, as you said at the top, down 3.4% as we stand. Brian Moynihan will be on closing bell at 3 p.m.
Oh, good. I look forward to hearing from him. Yeah, it's interesting the mixed response. I mean, overall, to what are strong numbers, at least, for this last quarter, Wolf.
Yeah, overall, the theme is all positive for all banks, particularly capital markets. But even with that slight disappointment you saw in JP Morgan's share price performance yesterday and Bank of America's today, even for the core business lines, loan growth hasn't picked up yet. Why? Because people have lots of cash and they're paying down debt. Has net interest income picked up in this quarter? No, not quite. But guidance for the rest of the year has, as if the yield curve continues to rise. I think you've got a sort of stock-specific aspect here with Bank of America on the costs. I wouldn't say it was purely that cost aspect. That was the trigger, and then you've seen a bit of selling since. We'll get more guidance from Brian Moynihan, no doubt, later.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.